Today we'll discuss about the roles of manager. So under roles of management, we'll be discussing mainly the roles of manager. So in this roles of manager, we have three main roles. One is interpersonal roles, informational roles, decisional roles. Under informational roles, manager has figurehead, leader and liaison. Under informational roles, monitor, disseminator, spokesperson. Under decisional roles, entrepreneur, disturbance handler, resource allocator, negotiator. So all these roles are the different roles which is done by the manager. First one is interpersonal roles. Interpersonal role is nothing but interaction with people, both organizational members and outsiders. Okay. So first one is figurehead role. So figurehead role is nothing but duties or managing the duties of ceremonial nature. Example, attending the functions of an employee or taking on customer to lunch. Leader. Leader's role is nothing but motivating the persons under working under the under them, means under manager. Okay. Also encouraging them to do the better work. Liaison is nothing but connecting link between his organization and outsiders. See, for example, this manager has to have the contacts with the people who are working outside his vertical chain also. Vertical chain means, see, managers, who are there in manager's vertical chain? Maybe above manager, there is a project main managers or project managers, okay, or the wing managers or someone. Under the manager, there will be team leads or senior software engineers. So that is his vertical chain, okay. And he will have contacts with his vertical chain. So according to liaison role, he must have the connection with the people other than his vertical chain, like clients or any other persons who is useful for his project or his work. Next one is informational roles. So this role is basically, it involves communication. Monitor, disseminator and spokesperson are the ones. Monitor means monitoring role. So collecting information about each and everything, okay, which is happening in and around him, so that basically if it is affecting his work, he will take care or he'll keep information about it. Disseminator is nothing but process giving what is required, only privileged information to the people who require it, that's all, not to others. Spokesperson representing his organization while interacting with outsiders. Okay, speaking about his organization, telling about his organization. Okay. So people may be, outside people may be customers or suppliers or financiers or any other governmental organizations. Next is decision roles. Decisional roles involves choosing most appropriate alternative among all of the all, so that organizational objectives are achieved in an efficient manner. Here we have entrepreneur, disturbance handler and negotiator. So, and the entrepreneurs are the ones basically who will look for the new ideas. Okay, so that the existing structure of the organization can be improved. Okay, next, or existing thing in an organization can be improved. Next one is disturbance handler. So this disturbance handler is nothing but if any problem comes in an organization, so that time how he deals with it. Okay. Disturbance handler, so that the normal functioning of the organization is restored. Negotiator is nothing but speaking with various groups in the organization and also the others like shareholders, okay, or any other agencies. One more thing which is not here is resource allocator, allocation of resources, okay, for the projects. Like for example, resources may be normal materials or maybe people. Like forming teams for the project to do specific task and all. Okay, so those are the decision roles. Then we speak about the levels, different levels of the management. So you have first line managers, middle managers and top level. And the top level we have president and executive vice president, and the middle level we have chief engineer, division heads. So division head, under division you have many managers. Okay, many projects. So those comes in the first line managers. Like under first line manager, you have foreman, supervisors and chief section chiefs. So these people come under first line managers. Okay. So this diagram simply gives an idea about who comes in which order. I mean which level. Basically, in the top level you can see which is represented in an oval, president and chairman. Then vice presidents of various things in an organization or various operations. Okay, so these are the organizational functions like operation, marketing, finance and resource. So these come under the middle level. Okay, this is all the rectangular whatever you can see here, the things. Okay, that is the middle level. And in the lower levels you have the particular managers of particular region, like RM, regional managers of north, south, east and west. Okay, so it is represented by the rectangle with the oval. Okay, so this is the lower level and these are middle and upper level. Okay, oval is upper level, rectangle is middle level, and a rectangle with an oval is a lower level. Okay, so what are the works now of the top level management? These people will determine the goals and objectives, okay, for that organization. And these are the people who are responsible for planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So students, remember, these are the functions of the management. Okay, next one is middle management. Middle management establishes programs for developing department and carries out functions for achieving specific goals. Okay, so whichever goals which are set by the upper level or higher level, these people will, in order to achieve that goal, these people will carry out the work. Okay, so that may be training and development of employees or integrating various parts of the departments for achieving the task. Supervisory management is a lower level. Okay, where people develop deal with one particular thing. Okay, so it's concerned with efficiency in using resources of the organization. Supervisor is an executor of policies, okay, and procedures, making a series of decisions with well-defined and specified premises. So what does this say, students? Policies and procedures are made by the higher level. We'll learn about policies and procedures in our future videos in detail. Okay, and these policies are made in upper level and executed in the lower level. Okay, that is supervisory management. So students, you know, we will know the skills. Okay, who should have which skills at which level. Okay, we can understand there are three types of skills: technical, interpersonal and conceptual skills. And in the lower level we see that the technical skills are required more, because we do the project there. That time you need a technical skill there to doing the project. Okay, and interpersonal skills are required equally in all the levels. Okay, and see here, technical skills are required less in the top level. Okay, interpersonal skills are nothing but communication things. See, it is required equally in all the levels. Conceptual skills is main skills, okay, for taking decisions and all. That is required, done in the top level usually. So that is required in the top level, more in top level. So these are the skills, students. So whatever we have just discussed, technical skills is specific subject related skills. Interpersonal skills are skills related to dealing with others and leading, motivating and controlling. So basically a communication skills. Conceptual skills is ability to discern the critical factors that will determine an organization's success or failure. Okay, so this is all we have in this particular video, students. Thank you.